I am Calvin Thomas, president of the Black Scholars Academy. And today our discussion is about gun control. And since, you know, Mr. Joshua Otis here, vice president, is a criminal justice major, I'm going to let him start off with the topic.
Okay. I don't like guns. I don't like guns, period, point blank. I feel like we should be like the other nations, Britain, Europe, and all of them. They don't have guns. Their police don't carry guns, I mean. They have billy clubs. I feel like that's a better way to stop guns altogether. Then our youth who get the guns, because at 18 you can get a machine gun without a gun license, but you can get a machine gun, not a handgun, for a low price, and that's how we have school shootings. Our crime rates are high. Yeah, this is how I feel.
Okay, now I'm gonna introduce Johnny Duncan, and after he's done, you know, speaking his opinion, we're gonna open it up to an open forum. Go ahead.
Well, when you talk about gun control, I think you gotta think about it also like this. I feel, you know, I think they need to bring the guns out. They need to take it out of cities, you know, because if you really think about it, we're so busy killing each other over nothing instead of trying to be humble and talk to each other, but we can't because people have egos and I want that person to feel so. I feel like it is bad, especially for gun control. But I can say it's also good because when actually a person do crime, actually who do a crime, they need to be locked up, you know? But that's just my opinion.
Okay, so my opinion, well, my question is open for him. My question is, do you feel that gun control laws will minimize crime between people?
No, I don't think so. The reason why I say that, because gun laws are, can you say it again, huh?
Do you feel that better gun laws, better, you know, stronger gun laws will bring down crime, bring down, you know, crime between people or those that carry guns?
My first statement, no, because we bring in guns from all over the nation. Then even if we don't have, we started going down on guns, like, let's fight guns. Let's put them in boxes, destroy them, all that. We can still get some from Mexico, Europe, and all, because we give, America is the strongest nation with weapons. We hand weapons over to other nations. And now we give them the same power like we do with ourselves. And they sell those guns back all the time. That's how we have gang shootouts, terrorist attacks, like we like to say, massacres, and all of that. Because America itself likes to hand out guns.
I mean, yeah, you're right. I can say that. But you also got to understand this. We are, we have a mindset. We choose to do what we want to. I mean, it's illegal to you can have a gun. You know what I mean? You can do whatever you want with it, but when you trying to harm somebody, and you wanna, when you trying to harm somebody, I feel like certain things don't really function. And it's like, why are you taking this person's life? So it's like, yes or no, you know. But I don't think we should. You know what I mean? Guns need to get out. Guns need to. I feel like, especially the government, and I don't want to go overboard, this is my opinion. I feel like the governments give it to people, that's how I believe. You know what I mean? I do, I believe you get permission to have one because you want your family to be safe. You want your people to feel okay, but what if your child pick up the gun and shoot themselves? You know what I mean? So I feel like it's good and bad. So, you know, that's how I feel.
Me, I feel like the gun laws do not, you know, minimize crime. It's the people with the gun ownership minimize crime. Mm-hmm. And I say that because when I look, supporting that, I had to look it up, and there was a quote, November 26, 2013 study found that between 1980 and 2009, assault weapons ban did not significantly affect murder rates, and at the state level and states with restrictions on the carrying of concealed weapons had a higher gun-related murders. So that's why I feel that if you try strengthening the gun laws, that's when, you know, the murder rates and the crimes that occur with concealed weapons or assault weapons that are illegal, they go up higher. So those that have the gun, the ownerships of the gun, they still have that right to own a gun, but it's the person that owns the gun, it's the person that has the gun that controls their own fate, that controls what happens with that. So it's not necessarily about the law, it's more of those people that own those guns that need to be put in check, especially, and those that buy a gun, it needs to be a better system of background checks when people buy the guns. The background checks need to, you know, be stronger, be better, and it has to go back further, because a lot of these people underage or people that have felonies, how are these people able to buy guns? And majority of the time, these guns are coming off of the black market or just a friend or the streets. But a lot of these incidents that happen, there is no way that, you know, people that have felonies or underage people can get access to illegal guns and not have the resources to conduct background checks.
Sorry to cut you off. And you feel like it's our politicians, policemen, we need to check more. Like our fellow officer Christopher Cockett would say, he always says that the politicians we need to check first. And from the politician, we work down. Is that's pretty much who we need to go after, the politicians?
I think the politicians really need to have more responsibility of what's going on. Lately, especially with the events that are happening, people are protesting and, you know, want a better gun law system, but it just seemed like, well, from what I've seen, it just seemed like the politician, even the P, is basically ignoring that, and especially trying to bring in the allowance to have teachers carry guns in school. That, my opinion, is the most
terrible thing.
It's the most terrible thing that I can think of, because what if there is, say, a regular teacher or a substitute teacher, something's going on, or say a fight break out, and the teacher feels it's their duty, you know, to pull out that gun, even though they have a right to carry the gun in school. What if a fight breaks out and no student or the teacher can't handle it? What they gonna do? Just, okay, you guys need to stop now. I'm going to shoot.
I mean, I feel like, when you come and not say our people, but people period, you got them people that like that extra, you know what I mean? That want it. I need that scene, you know what I mean? Maybe pointing at somebody, not say make them understand, but basically make them learn a lesson. But I feel like, you right, whatever did pop off, boom, and hit somebody. You know what I mean? Who fault would be that? You know what I mean? Now you gotta look at that professor or substitute. It's like, wow, I shot this child or whatever because they didn't want to calm down. You know what I mean? And you see a lot of events that go on like that in the world we live in. When somebody do something, then when a big incident go crazy, everybody want to go nuts. Then, and I don't want to sound crazy like what I said, but I just think like I feel like we are born to, I would say learn life, but I feel like making decisions and doing things, I feel like that's your responsibility, but I feel like other people shouldn't be responsible about what other people do. Like, that's how I feel, you know?
Then you're saying, okay, in general, I understand what you're saying, but do you feel like the schools itself should, both of you, mm-hmm. feel like the school systems itself should tell their teachers you cannot have guns on school property?
I mean, I think, like, I feel like yes or no, you know what I mean? I think we do, because you got people lives, you know what I mean? You go to school every day, and you know how the world we live in, people are crazy, people love that attention. So of course, like I remember we was all, y'all probably all could remember this, when we'd be in middle school or high school when they had the fire little drills, everybody had to go out, go by their lockers and go on the floor, you know what I mean? Or when they be like, everybody stay in class, we got somebody in the building. So of course, you gotta think about that. Of course, you gonna feel afraid. You got people life in danger, people feeling like, oh, I can't do nothing or something, you know? So yeah, but I mean, maybe the other person opinion probably would feel like, well, no, we don't need it because, you know, people out here is dying every day, you know. We should try to feel safe, but in the world we live in, it's not. So, you know.
In your opinion, Charlie?
I think that it should be more education about guns to prevent accidental deaths or things that may occur. I think that a lot of children or teens or even adults, it's the gun control. Yeah, it's okay to have gun control laws, but don't try to exceed them. I think you should invest more into the education of the guns for these children, teens, and adults to learn more about guns and gun safety. Because the recent event with the little kid, I think he was a middle schooler, shooting himself in the bathroom, and he died. I don't necessarily know if it was accidental or if it was on purpose, but at the same time, it should have been prevented on the school bus, should have prevented in the house from even carrying a gun. It should have been prevented on the school bus. It should have been prevented of him walking into the school with a gun.
Then how would, I'm just going to go back to the school bus, how would the school bus take action on guns? Because some kids do carry guns in their bag.
Well, I feel like this.
School buses.
You don't check them. Look, it's like this. And that's why I feel like people be like, oh, parents don't need to be tough on you. Sometimes you need that. You know what I mean? I mean, it's good to, you know, raise your child right and tell them what certain stuff. But when you dealing with a world out here, and when you got people that's cruel, I'm not saying don't take it, you know what I mean? Because I remember when I was in school, when people would get bullied or whatever, they always say, hey, go tell the teacher. But now, you know, people try to handle it in their own way, you know what I mean? Now, you could go to any parent, especially a black parent, I mean, even including white, they're going to tell their child to, you know, offend for yourself, you know? But I think when it comes to trying to, you know, like, I feel bad for that young brother who did that. You know, I don't think he should have did that, but maybe he felt that he wanted attention. But I don't think he should have had attention like that. You don't need to hurt yourself because what's going on. You let a person know what's going on, especially if you a kid, but when you're a grown adult, it's just certain levels you just can't take, and I feel like you can handle yourself in a responsible way, in a respectful way, to let people know, like, look, a lot of things just, it gotta be dead. But some people, they just don't have that. They don't have that. They like that.
Okay, about what I was saying, I'm gonna read another statement. It says 95% of all U.S. gun owners believe that children should learn about gun safety. Guns don't kill people, people kill people. Mm-hmm. And people need more gun education and mental illness screenings to prevent massacres. So a lot of these accidental deaths and things that's been going on, it goes back to what I was saying. I think it should be more education about gun safety. And I believe that the ones that should only have a gun in school are those, you know, specially trained police officers and security guards that are able or allowed to carry a gun. So my opinion on teachers being allowed to carry guns in school is unnecessary, man. It's not cool because, okay, let me just say this real quick before we wrap it up. I feel the education about gun safety needs to be put in place. It's okay to have gun laws, but don't try to exceed it to where the politicians take more control and take out the guns from the citizens. And it's unethical for teachers to carry guns, because any accidental occurrence that happened or a thing that they can't control is out of their hand, they're gonna accidentally try to pull out their gun, and some accident is gonna happen. So I feel like teachers should not be allowed to carry guns in school. So with that being said, we are going to cut it down now, and we're going to bring you another video. This is Calvin Thomas, president of the Black Scholars Academy. This is our discussion forum.